So I was recently asked by somebody if there's a way to record like a video diary using your Mac. After all, most Macs, the iMacs and the MacBooks, have a camera right there. And while you could type out a diary, some people would prefer to actually record some audio or maybe just use the camera and do some video. It's a great way to keep a journal, and it must be really fun to look back years later to see about what you were doing with your day, how you felt, that kind of thing. So it's actually really easy to do this with built-in software. There's some expensive apps that you could buy that will, you know, allow you to organize your stuff. But you could just do this using QuickTime Player. QuickTime Player has player in the name, but it actually can record as well. So you can launch QuickTime Player using Spotlight, Command Space, and QuickTime Player. I've moved it to the dock just for easy access. And instead of opening a document to play, you can go to File and then New Movie Recording. And this will then show you your camera and you can choose things here. Notice this little down arrow next to the record button. You can choose which camera. So I've got my Mac Pro here. I've got a whole bunch of different video sources. But you would normally just choose your regular built-in camera. It's probably the only thing that appears there. And I also have a variety of different audio sources, microphones. You would just, again, choose your internal microphone. And you can choose quality. You probably, for something like this, just want to stick with high and not maximum so the files aren't too big. And then you could just hit record. And then you could talk about your day and how you feel and maybe things you have planned, that kind of thing. And when you're done, you just hit stop again. Now nothing's actually happened. You haven't saved the file. So the great thing is if, say, you have a false start, you start and then you say, no, I'm going to start again, you can basically just close this window, delete, and it's gone. And then you could just start the process again. It's really nice and easy. There's no file to find and delete. But at this point, if it's what you want, you can save. So you can do File and you can do Save, Command S, and you could save it to the desktop. So let me say diary, and I could just number them. Do one, or I could do like a date in some sort of format and save that out. Now another option you may want to do is instead of saving, go right to Export. So you can export as, and you could do a lower resolution. So like if I don't want anything special for this, I can do 480p, which is like standard definition video. So I can do that as a file. Now that's going to export it out. And if I hadn't saved it already and I tried to quit, it would say, hey, you haven't saved this. But you can just say delete it because I want to just keep this file there. So you can see here's the two files. This one here is actually 9 megs. And that was only for a few seconds of me recording. This one here, I'm just doing Command I, is 2.8 megs. So you can see the difference here is, you know, here's the size of this one. And you can see the quality is still pretty good. It's just a small video frame. And this one's much bigger. So depending upon what you want, that is how you could save it out. I would probably like for a diary for myself, if it's just going to be me talking and I'm not going to be showing anything special, just save it in a compact format like that. Now, when you got Info, Command I after selecting the file, notice there are other things you can do as well. Like for instance, there's comments down here. So if you wanted to add comments, some sort of text to the diary, then you could do that. And actually this is searchable. So if you were to actually just put a couple keywords in there or just a quick description of what it is you talked about, you can actually search and do a find on files and that video will show up. The video, the find function can't actually hear what you're saying in the video and kind of index that. But it can do it with the comment in here. So for instance, if you're talking about a particular person in your diary, you can maybe mention that person in there. And then later on when you do a search, if there were 5 video entries that you mentioned that person and you recorded them all in comments, you could easily find them that way. So this is kind of a fun, interesting thing to do. Just using the software that's completely in your Mac, I would like create a folder maybe in your documents folder called diary or video diary, and stick the files in there. When you go to view them, you could view by list and you could see the date. So you can easily sort them by date go back and kind of keep this video diary of what you're doing a lot easier than writing for a lot of people and a lot more interesting than just recording some audio.